Namaskar learners, I am Dr. Priya Rai. Welcome to the program of Library and Information Science at Senior Secondary level. In the last program, we have discussed about arrangement and maintenance of library material. The topic of today's program is Library and Information Services for the Users. Libraries since ago ages have stored materials that enables idea, knowledge and experiences to be passed on from generation to generation. Libraries built collections tailored to the need and the goal of the organization that they serve. For example, academic libraries built collections of students, teachers and researchers. This collection is systematically organized by the library for use of the users. The library collection serves as an important resource in education, work and recreation of millions of people. Earlier, libraries were considered merely storehouse of knowledge and the librarian as a custodian of the collection. Present day libraries are different. They are considered as educational and service institutions. Here, libraries not only organize the collection but provide assistance to library users in various ways to support learning, interest and other vocation related to activities. The assistance and services provided by the librarians can be broadly grouped as reference and information services. These services promote the use of library materials, connect the users with library resources and meet the information need of the users. The objective of the module, the basic objective of creating these modules is to make you explain the need and importance of services offered by the library. List out the types of services offered by libraries that is essential and desirable. Describe various essential services. Identify and discuss various desirable services. Elaborate upon the types of services offered by academic, special and public libraries. Need of the information. Now we'll discuss about what are the need of the creation and distribution of information. Information is crucial for all our activities. People need information for study, research, for pursuing their career, healthcare, problem solving, recreation and lifelong learning. Everybody needs information for some purpose or the other. For example, students need information to supplement their textbook studies and for the project work. Teachers need information for teaching and research. Professionals like doctors, engineers, consultants need information to pursue their career efficiently. Planners and policy makers need information to frame policies and take correct decisions. Researchers need information to keep up to date in their area of research, to find out new area of research and to solve any research problem. There are various types of information need of the user. The broadly categorized four types of information need are current information need, exhaustive information need, everyday information need and catching up information need. Current information need, when library users need information to keep themselves up to date with the latest development in the area of interest on a regular basis, the need is known as current information need. Exhaustive information need, when a library user wants to have information on particular topic as exhaustive as possible, the need is known as exhaustive information need. Researchers mainly have this type of information need when they start their research work. Another form of information requirement is everyday information need. This is the need for the specific piece of information which users need required in their day-to-day activity. The need is generally for factual information which is normally available in standard reference books. The another form of information need is catching up information need. It arises when a user who is not conversant with a particular subject fields requires an account of overall development of the subjects in a short and compact format. Library services. Now viewers, we'll discuss about various types of library services. To meet information need of users, library provides a ranges of services which is broadly classified into information services and reference services. Library services. Reference services, now we are discuss about, are concerned with direct personal assistance to the user seeking information. Means when a user comes to work directly for any sort of help, the reference services section provide them the concerned information. It covers direct services such as assistance to the user in the use of library and its tools, assisting in searching and locating document. Ready reference on long range reference services, literature search and compilation of bibliographies help in researching. Now there is an indirect services such as selection, organization and maintenance of library material for reference services, and another task of reference services such as keeping the records of reference queries, preparing for publicity material, evaluation of reference section, etc. Information services are provided in anticipation to various needs of the user of the library. Current awareness service, indexing and abstracting services, etc. falls under the information services. At times, these services are provided on the demand of the user, means when a user comes to us, they proactively come to the library and ask for such kind of information, then this information services are being provided to them. Now we will bifurcate about the reference services and information services. Well, reference services are a traditional service, traditional form of services, whereas information services is a non-traditional format of a services. Reference services basically emphasize in providing documents only, whereas information services emphasizes is on providing information, not only document, but the information in any format, whether it is in a print format or it is in an electronic format. So, user is given the material or directed to locate the material in reference services, whereas opposite to information services, attempt to provide exact information, means the correct information and right information and particular information is being given to the users who come for the assistance. In reference services, aim is to instruct the user, whereas in information services, less concerned with the instructing users. In reference services, service provides on demand, means whenever user comes to us on demand, we provide the information, which is opposite to the information services, where services provide in anticipation of the need, means we find out the need and the subject of the users, and whenever we come across and we find the information in anticipations, we provide the information to the user. Reference service is a passive services. Library staff waits for the user to approach them and make the demand. The again word passive services means on request of a demand of a user who approaches to the, who comes to the library, whereas information services, it's an active services. We don't need to wait for the user to come to the library and ask for the information. The staff provides services in anticipation, means in advance to keep user well informed. So whenever a new information comes in any sort of format, whether it is electronic format or it is in a print format, it automatically being sent to the user as per their demand. Now, what are the basic or essential services rendered by all type of library? Now, we are going to discuss about it. The basic and essential services rendered by all type of libraries are lending or circulation services, where we do issue and return of the books basically, or the documents of the library, authorized users. Then there comes an interlibrary loan services. Interlibrary loan services, we exchange the information outside with the different libraries. we have a reference services where we provide the information to the user on the demand. The library orientation, basically the library orientation is teaching the user about how to use a library. Reservation of a document, whenever document is been needed by somebody and is already been lended to somebody else, then the document is reserved for a particular person. Another form of services which is being rendered by the libraries are assistance in the use of library and library tools. So whenever the users comes to use the in library, the library staff explain them about the various tools available in library for their reference work. And readers advisory services, this is another form of library service. Now, lending and circulation, as I have smallly discussed in the previous slide, what is lending and circulation services, now we will discuss about in detail. The learners, the service is concerned with lending of books and other library material to the registered member of the library for a specific period of time. It depends upon the library what time period they wanted to keep for issuing of the certain books. It is for whether some libraries make it for 1 week, some make it for 2 days, some making it for 3 days. It's totally upon depends upon the rules and regulations of a library that how many days the period they wanted to lend the information to the user. The another format is the service is known as a circulation, also known as a circulation service. For this purpose, each library follows a particular issue system for lending the books to the users and receiving them back from the users. So one point is issuing, the another point is receiving back from the users so that it comes back to the library at a particular time. So all libraries, whether it is an academic library, public library, special libraries, offers this type of services. Means all sort of library offers the circulation and lending of the books or the documents of the library to their authorized user. The rule and regulation of circulation services may be differ from library to library. In some libraries, issue and return of the books are handled manually, and in some library services is computerized. But in most of the libraries, the services of issue return has become a computerized or computer operated, because many more softwares has come up to help us out in commercial platform as well as in open source software available. So most of the library are now converted from manually to computerized. The another format is reservation of a book. This is really very important in a library. We as a learners, as a librarian, this is our duty to preserve the library document for the next client or next users which really demands and really needed the books for urgently needed a book for any special consultation or urgent consultation. So this service is being created in viewing and keeping in view these issues, like reservation of a document is one of the important service of the library. In this service, the library makes provision to reserve a book in the user's name, and when the required book is already issued to someone else and is not available in the library, whether the book is returned by the borrower or the library informs the user whose name the book is reserved so that he and she can get the particular book issued for the use. This service is basically being created for optimum use of information, means the information which is lying in a library in a form of a book, document, manuscript, any format, it should optimum be used as per the rule and regulation of the, as per the law of the Ranganathan, it should be optimum and maximum used by the users. So this service is particularly meant for that. So all library, whether academic, public or special library, they build collection to fulfill the need of their users as well as to support the mission of the parent institution which they are belongs. So in for that, an interlibrary loan service has been created. However, no library, even the longest one, can afford to have a sufficient collection to satisfy all the requirements of the users. So learners, the basic motive of making this service available, interlibrary loan, is to have the information of the library to the user or to provide the information to the users of the library which is available in another library, is not available in our library in which we are serving, so that we can request them and they can return back the, they can issue the book for us for a particular period, so that we can be able to satisfy the demand of the users. So, at times the users require a document that is not available in our own library. Sometimes this happens, but may be available in some other library. For this, library usually have an arrangement with the other libraries to share their resources on reciprocal basis, means we will provide you the information if the information is available with another library for our user, and we will provide you our material, you provide your material to us on a reciprocal basis. So, under this agreement, the required document is then borrowed from other library on interlibrary loan and is given to the user for the access. So, assistance in the use of library and library tool. Now, we will discuss about that, how a librarian can give and help and provide their optimum assistance to the users who comes to the library for the access by with the help of different types of tools and technologies available within our library. So, one of them is assistance in the use of library collection and library tools such as cataloging includes OPAC. OPAC is Online Public Access Catalog. It is basically a catalog but is available in electronic format in place of the print catalog format. Now, the technology has given us lot of opportunity to convert many things. So, this is one of the important thing, it's Online Public Access Catalog. So, reference book etc. is provided to the users who are not familiar with the library. So, this information is sought by the users who visit to the library for the first time. Such readers need directional guidance in the use of library. Suppose a new user enter in a library and he doesn't know where the things are being arranged by the librarian. So, we guide them that these are the information, different format of the information, these are the tools available like OPAC for searching a particular book or searching a particular journal volume. They can easily access through the use of OPAC, which is lying in a computer in a library. So, they need to know the general layout of the library, location of the newspapers, magazine, display racks, location of the textbooks, reference books, availability of the card catalog if it is a manual library, or computer terminal for searching the library collection. So, the different tools which are available in library in a form of a catalog, cards, which lead them or help them where a particular book or document is located, so that they can search the information in a card or computerized way and directly go to the section for taking out the information. So, these are the tools available in a library. Now, we'll discuss about the reference services. So, reference services is personalized services which is provided in a response to the request of the user. We have already discussed in the previous slides that what is a reference services and how it is being provided. Now, we'll discuss in little bit in detail about these services which is being provided by the reference desk or reference section of the library. So, request may come for locating an answer to the fact finding questions, for literature search, for solving research problem, for compiling a bibliography on a journal help. So, viewers, in these services, the persons or the users comes to the library, asks for the demand in which he is not able to access the information to the reference desk of the library, and the specialized librarian who are specialized in a particular subject area, they take out or dig out the information from different sources which are available in library and provide to the users. So, Dr. Ranganathan also defines library services as personal services to each reader in helping him to finding documents, answering his interest most pinpointedly, exhaustively and expeditiously. So, he also says that to provide the right book to the right reader in the right personal way. This is what the Ranganathan has said, that a book or the information or a material should be provided to the users at right time in a right way, so that we will be able, as a librarian, we will be able to save their time. So there are many other services which are concerned connected with the reference services, ready reference services. There are some ready reference information available which are being provided to the user, long range reference services, readers advisory services, and users orientation. So now we'll discuss about the types of question and source to be consulted. We know that there are many things lying in a library. When we enter in a library, we see a lot of information and lot of books and lot of things, especially the primary sources and secondary sources and tertiary sources are lying in a library. But what covers? So we'll discuss about it and how the types of questions help in that. So for grammar and literature, if somebody will say, how should I pronounce the word schedule? So grammar and language, we have a language dictionary. For background information on a topic, we have a general encyclopedias available in a library, like Encyclopedia Britannica. It's available in most of the library for background information on a particular topic. Actually, these encyclopedias are arranged in a systematic order subject wise. Then for trends, we have a yearbooks, means yearbooks on a particular topic about, discuss about the new technologies and new things which is coming up in a particular subject area. Then places, if we wanted to know something about the places, like how geographically places are being there, then we have a geographical sources or general encyclopedia. If we wanted to know about the peoples, about the know about who's who, about the who's who of the of a particular country, of a whole world, then there's a geographical, biographical sources, general encyclopedia. So this biographical sources discussed about the who's who peoples or the known peoples and about their brief information and sketch about their biography. Then for organizations, suppose I wanted to know about the particular organizations, their name, address, something like that, then we have a dictionaries for that. So now learners, we will discuss about the need of other desirable services. Why these other than the services which we have discussed, why we need to have more services for the users? So during the 20th century, particularly after the World War II, there was tremendous increase in the research activity all over the world. This resulted in an exponential growth of a published literature, particularly in a field of science and technology. Government-sponsored research, particularly in the area of space science, defense science, nuclear science, and also contributed in this growth. So the interdisciplinary nature of the above frontline areas of research resulted in scattering of information in different disciplines. Like means that the information is being scattered in different subject areas. So it was difficult, very difficult to find out the relevant and right information as said by the Ranganathan, and I have discussed in my previous slide, to a user at a right time. The research results were being bought out in a wide range of publications. I mean, there are lot of publications which have come up in the form of journals, in the form of a book, in the form of a dictionary. So it was difficult to arrange them in a proper order, such as primary periodicals, research report, conference proceedings, thesis, dissertation, patent. Many information has come up in society. Sometimes it's explained about the particular subject and sometimes a wide ranges of subject. So as a consequence, the growth of volume, diversity and complexity of the information source, user, particularly science and technology researchers and manager, found it difficult to keep track of the latest development in an area of interest. To solve this problem, particularly scientific and technical libraries and information centers attached to the research and development organizations, R&D organization, starting, they think about it, that it's being scattered all over in a very odd manners. So they started collecting, selecting and organizing latest published literature in a specific discipline and bringing to the notice of the researcher as a service of a regular basis. So these are also desirable services, which is really very important. The provision of these services lead to the demand of other services like reprographic services, document delivery services, translation services, literature search, and compilation of subject bibliography and reference services, advances in computer and communication technology and use of computers in library raises the demand of IT related services. So, other desirable services, current awareness, condensation, literature search, reprographic, document delivery, translation, reference service, user training, referral service and IT related services. So, current awareness type. So, we all know that current awareness system provides a list, it provides content of journal, it provides selective dissemination and newspaper clipping. Condensation service provides basically abstracting and digest services. Literature search and compiling a subject bibliography, it basically provides subject bibliography on a particular subject and literature search only on the basis of a demand. So, reprographic services, we know that reprographic is basically photocopying, photography, microfilming, printout and digital imaging. So, basic library work is a photocopying and photocopy of the document to providing to the users. So, viewers, we know that document delivery services are being provided by Dellnet, Infilmnet and Niskier. Basically, they supply the document on the basis of demand, original or photocopy of a journal article irrespective of the location. Then translation services, Niskier is the main body who basically do the translation services from one language to another language by the expert or the subject expert engaged. There are referral services. Basically, referral services are those services when the information is not available in a library, they are the users has been referred to the other library for providing of the information. We have already discussed about the user training. So, we have a user orientation, user education, guided tour. These are being provided to the users when they enter first time in a library by the staff of the library to help them to find a document located in a different sections of the library. We have information technology related services. Now, the technology has given us a lot of information and lot of possibilities to do and to help the reader and the researchers. Online public access catalog, we have discussed, we have been provided to the, is been available in a desktop of a library for accessing the information electronic. We have a library website, virtual reference services are being provided, means the users have not been given the print material, but electronic the information is been given to them. We have a computerized circulation services, access to e-publications, the electronic availability of e-literature is there. So, the user sitting at any remote location of the place, geographical plate, they can access the information which is been subscribed by a particular library. Then types of library and services offered. We all know that library are divided into academic library, public library and special libraries. Academic library are basically school library, college libraries and university libraries. So, we all know that school library, the basic services are reader's advisory service. In college library, the level is little bit high, the library instructions at the beginning of the sessions and it provide basically the research material engaged in the student for the use of a particular subject area being told by the teachers. Then we have a university library. The services are more advanced in a university library, like reference services and current awareness services are being provided to them. Indexing, abstracting services, document delivery services are many types of services are provided in a university libraries because the entry of the students are little bit in an advanced level. They are niche students and they require information on a particular subject. Then we all know that public libraries are for the general public. Anybody who is a student, housewife, professional, businessman, retired person, anybody can, being a member of a public library, can come to the library and can use the information in the library. But the main purpose is imparting local information about the local institutions. Reader advisory services are being given in a public library for children and housewife, and collection of information and recreational activities are being done in a public library to serve better and provide many other services as well. Then we have a special library. The word itself explains what is special. Special library means a library which caters the needs of a user of a particular subject. Means the information of a particular subject is available in special library. Special libraries are attached to R&D organizations such as library, which serves or specialize in research and development, actively engaged in a particular subject discipline. So, the specialized library serves to the research and development personals only. Then we have a special library services. They provide responsive and anticipatory services, current awareness services, content by service journal, indexing apps, abstracting, document delivery and online database service. There are many services which we have discussed earlier also. They provide these type of services to the users who have a special request or particular subject based request to the library. Now viewers, learners, we have learned, we'll discuss about what we have learned in this modules. We have learned libraries provide reference and information services to user to meet the information requirement of the user. Reference services is concerned with direct personal assistance to the users seeking information. Information services are provided in anticipation to various needs of the users of the library. These services are provided on demand from the users. Basic or essential services offered by all type of library is irrespective of the type of size are lending services, reservation document, interlibrary loan, assistance to the use of library and the library tools, reference services, readers, advisory services and library orientation. Growth in volume, diversity and complexity of information resources, advances in information and communication technology, change in information seeking behavior of the users has resulted in increased demand of information services including IT based services. So services offered under other desirable services are current awareness, condensation, literature search, compiling subject bibliographies, reprographic service, document delivery services, translational services, referral services and information technology related services. Thank you viewers for patiently listening and learning about this module. We will meet with another module.